Hello! Today I'm going to show you how you can mask data to enforce data privacy for sensitive data, such as personal information, vendor information, or trade secrets. In this demonstration, I will be using NextLabs Data Access Enforcer, or DAE, to mask data, which can be used for a broad range of applications and databases. For this example, I will be using SAP. In this tutorial, I am going to specify that specific fields, such as the bank key and bank account number, should be masked for all users who are not authorized to view the data. First, I will show you how this policy is created in the NextLabs Control Center. The masking policy has several components. First is in the policy effect section, where you can define which users the policy will apply to. You can either specify specific users, or you can use attributes, such as the department the user is in, which is what we are doing here, to restrict or provide access to users. In this case, we are masking the data for any user who is not part of the finance department. The second component of the policy is the resource components section, where you can specify which system the policy should be applied to. The next component of the policy is the action component. In this case, we are applying the policy on the select action. Final component to the policy is defined in the obligation section. Here's where we can specify the data masking should be applied, whether we want full or partial data masking, and what should be shown for the masked data. In this case, we are displaying asterisks instead of the actual data. Now that we have the data masking policy defined, we can see the impact of the policy within SAP. First, we will see that of the two users, one of them is assigned to the finance department and does have access to the bank data, and the other is not, will only see masked values. Here's demo user 01, which we can see is part of the purchasing department. When we show you the data later, you'll see that for demo user 1, they will see masked values for the bank details that we specified. Now, if we look at demo user 2, we can see that they are part of the finance department and will be able to see the values, the sensitive bank values. So now, since we are logged in as demo user 1, we will go and attempt to view the data. We're going to be viewing the data in the bank, in the customer data table, which is KNBK. And then we can see the data in the table. As you can see, the fields that we specified are masked to demo user 1. We can also choose to view a customer record. If we go to the Payment Transactions tab, we can see that the bank details are masked in this tab as well. Now we will open another browser where we have logged in as Demo User 2. Here we can see that we are logged in as Demo User 2. As you can see, for demo user 2, they are able to see the bank account information because it is not masked. This is because this user is a member of the finance department and the data masking policy does not apply to them. Here we can also open the customer record. And within the payment transactions tab, we can see that the bank data is not masked here as well. This concludes a demonstration of the data masking functionality in DAE for SAP.